Hey y'all, it's Meso. Welcome to my channel today. Come on into my kitchen where we're going to be doing something really good. I'm taking you to the country today, baby. We're going to go get that country fried corn. Look at that. Let's see what it's going to take to make it happen. So here I have some corn. This is mixed corn, a little bit of mixed yellow and white. I paid $3.50 for one pack. It has three ears of corn in it, and I have three packs here. I've already washed my corn. I've taken those little sears, those little strings. They're called sears. I've taken them off, and I cleaned it up real good. I have a bowl here, and a big bowl. I have a small bowl in it that's turned upside down. I'm using that bowl to elevate my corn up out of the big bowl so that I can cut it without my knife bumping into the bowl and just not having enough room, period. So I'm getting up high, kind of slanting that corn on the bowl, and I am cutting it off and scraping the cob. Now, I was talking about those sears, and some people call them strings or whatever, but when the corn is just growing, those sears are pink and yellow, and they're so soft and pretty. When I was a kid, sometimes we would play in the garden, and we would plait those, braid those sears up and pretend like they were people. Yeah. Okay, so here you see that I am cutting this corn from the cob. I am cutting first time. My first cut is about halfway down. Then I might make a second cut, but always at the end, I'm going to come back and scrape. Look, I'm scraping that. Look, I'm going to scrape this. Now, of course, I have to speed it up. I can't scrape that fast, but I'm going to cut it. You see that first I'm cutting about half of the corn off. I get the second part of it, and then I come back and scrape, baby. You got to scrape these corn until they're just nothing but cobs. Nothing on them. You don't want any moisture, any nothing on them. So when I scrape it that last time, what comes out of that is like milk. And that's what's going to cream your corn when you get that milk. It's so important. I have seen people do this, and they'll throw that cob. Look at there. See what I'm talking about? Nothing in those holes. Those holes are empty, barren of any kind of juice, milk, or corn. I've seen people throw that straight into the trash can, and I cringe. Like, no, you're leaving all your corn behind. Here, I'm just showing you how to get this small bowl out. It makes a little bit of a suction. So just use the point of your knife to lift it up instead of trying to dig it out with your fingers. We're going to go ahead and get this little bit of seasoning, this little bit of seasoning onto the corn. Don't need a lot at all. Corn is very delicate. I just put in some sugar, about 2 tablespoons. You don't have to put this in at all if you don't want to. I am putting in 1/2 cup of flour and 1/2 cup of water. Now you got to use that flour. That's not optional when you're talking about frying corn. So I'm not even going to put any salt in it, not needed. As I was saying, corn is very delicate, and you don't put a lot of spices or strong flavors in corn. It's the flavor that it has is enough. Okay, look at that. Now you can already see that mixture. I've got the liquid in there. That's about what I want. Here I am melting a stick of butter, and I have some coconut oil. So because I like coconut oil, I am just going to add about 2 tablespoons of coconut oil to this stick of butter. Now you say, that's a lot of butter, Miso. Well, that's how fried corn goes. You can't do this now with canned corn or frozen corn. I've been to events and they said they're having fried corn. I get there and they've got frozen corn. Hey, I want to show you something. See that my butter is brown? Now, I want my butter to be brown rather than just melting it. I like that brown butter flavor because it's sort of nutty, delicious in the corn. But yeah, they'll say we're having fried corn, and I get there and they've got some canned corn and mushed up some flour, junk, or whatever it is in there. And then they'll call that fried corn. That's not fried corn. No, baby, I got to give you the truth today. Now, I put a little black pepper in mine because I like black pepper. If you don't like black pepper, don't put it in yours. Can you see my corn becoming thicker? But yeah, you have to have, you cannot use frozen, you can't use canned. Anybody giving you that and telling you that's fried corn, well, it might be fried corn, but it's not Southern country fried corn. My grandmother used to fry corn so good you want to grab that frying pan and run out the door, go around the house and eat the whole pan by yourself, not share none of it. And look at this. This is just that same kind of cornbread, honey. Miso has served you up. Look at this. Oh, let's go ahead and get in. Don't waste any more time. Let's taste this corn. This is country, baby. Honey, country. Look at that. Get closer. Smooth and creamy. Oh, yeah. Thumbs up, of course. Big old thumbs up, of course, honey. It don't get no better than this. This is simple, fresh, clean. I had to sneak back in here. I wasn't even going to show you this. I'll show you these pork chops. These were very thin, almost tissue paper thin. I just seasoned them. No batter or flour. Put them in the oven, let them cook about 20 minutes. And looky, looky. Oh, they're so good. I got my peas, I got my corn, got my pork chop. What else do I need? How to get any better than this? Guys, I appreciate you coming by to see what I was doing today, because you knew that miso would be throwing down, and I hope I did not disappoint. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Give it a big old thumbs up. Push the like button. If you also like my channel, I want you to subscribe. Also hit that notification bell so that you'll know and be notified every time I put up a new video. I want you to share my videos wherever you're active on social media. I want you to also leave me comments, because I love hearing from you guys. What do you have to say? Y'all, 2020 was pretty rough, but that has passed. And behold, all things are new again. 2021 is going to be prosperous. We're going to walk in health, wholeness, and happiness. And all the love that you have inside of you, make sure that you share that with somebody else. Y'all, thank you for watching. I appreciate you so much, and I love you.